Texas, and that's the southernmost eastern tip of Texas, and right on the Gulf, the water's right over there. Incredible things are serial number one and serial number two. They're stainless steel alloy spaceships. These are the prototypes. They're gonna go through a few of these. And the plan, it's SpaceX. They're gonna go to the moon and then to Mars. They're gonna actually use these to go to Mars. So now normally you think, this is so weird looking. Why would, this looks like something from 1950s or 1930s. You know, it's big, heavy, because this is a lot heavier than the really sophisticated carbon composite material or the aluminum alloys they use in all of the rockets. Why are they building like this? They're building like this because even though it's really heavy, because steel is so good at handling high temperatures, so when it comes back in, it hits the Earth's atmosphere, well, steel handles it a lot better. So the heat shields are a lot lighter than the heat shields they have to use on the other ships, the other rocket ships, which all of their companies use, which is carbon composite. So that's why they can actually make it about the same weight, but it's way cheaper to make. So Elon Musk, the CEO, what he wants is a gigantic industry. Well, this is like 2% or 10% the cost of the other of carbon composite or the aluminum alloy, and they can make it right here. They make it on site. You know, they have welders and fabricators, and they look really funny. But see how the one on the right—that's the first seal number. See how it's all dented? Well, the one on the left—that's the next generation. So they're getting better at the welding. They've already done a couple where they've got it to 150 feet. The next one is going to be 20 kilometers. Could happen in a few months. Right down the road. Incredible sight. We'll try to get on camera. But this is like beginning of something really big, because he's doing something that NASA's not doing. He's got a new rocket engine. You know, it's called full flow stage combustion. They're using a different fuel called methane, and it's something that NASA's not doing. And the reason why he's doing that is because if they get to Mars, they can make methane on Mars, and so they can get back. So, and he plans on like having 1,000 of these things, 1,000, do like do one a day, and then like within 10 years, every 26 months, you have to go for Mars. You can only do it once every 26 months when the alignment comes up, when the revolutions align. So they're gonna send out a fleet of ships to Mars. Ones that are automated, have all the material, then they'll start sending humans out. He honestly plans on having cities on Mars within our lifetime, maybe 30, 40 years, but to Mars within, I don't know, he says like 5, which is probably 10 years. But probably to the moon in just a few years. But that looks like a 1950s rocket ship. And they're building here in Texas. And they're hiring all these people, and they're going to build down the road. And they call this Stargate, SpaceX. And it's cooler than heck. Let's see if we can get something in. You see that big thing left? They're going to probably start fabricating on the inside. It's such a cool thing.